Welcome to Morning Manna with Pastor Steve Myrie. Today's topic, sow your seed, cast your net, and let God handle the rest. Another parable put he forth unto them, saying, the kingdom of heaven is like unto a grain of mustard seed, which a man took and sowed in his field, which indeed is the least of all seeds. But when it is grown, it is the greatest among the herbs, and becometh a tree, so that the birds of the air come down and lodge in the branches thereof. Matthew 13:31-32. We need to understand the power of the word. We go through life looking for answers a lot of the time and looking for purpose, and all along it was in our hands. Truly the gospel is the seed that the scripture speaks of. And to most men it seems to be the least of all seeds. In other words, of all the ideas and philosophies in life, the gospel seems to be the least appealing. But when it is planted, it will grow and become a tree. I'm talking about something firm, something established with roots that cannot be blown by the winds of life. That is what we all need in this world today. Something firm and consistent, something unfailing, and something that will replenish. Think about it like this. All those birds are flying around looking for a place to land and to rest. And it was upon the greatest tree that they chose to find rest. What does the scripture say? Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. There are people going around seeking for a place of rest, a place to find security and peace. And it is time we offer the world something else other than just religion and ideas about their situations and philosophies that don't hold any water. People are looking for rest. That is what Jesus gave to us, and we should freely give it to the world. We are told in Matthew 13 about the four different places where the seed went. Now, after observing the other grounds, it can become confusing. You may ask, why would anyone who knows anything about farming and cultivation would ever take good seed and plant it among the wayside or on the road where they knew it could not find root, or among rocks where it could not possibly find depth? Why among thorns where there was no root for it? Then as you get deeper into the word and the Lord opens your understanding, you realize that the sower was not called to make the decision of where the gospel would fall, but only to sow it everywhere and among all places. How judgmental are we at times, though our hearts were full of stones, and though our hearts were full of thorns, though we were living about the wayside, Christ sowed the gospel in our hearts time and time again until something happened. Church, don't try to help God. Just obey Him and His command. Let us cast our nets. Let us compel all men unto God. That is our job. That is our calling. Let us allow God, who is all-wise, all-knowing, and all-seeing, the Alpha and Omega, decide who stays and who goes, who is worthy and who is not. Sow your seed, cast your net, and let God take care of the harvest. The thought of the day, you realize that the sower was not called to make the decision of where the gospel would fall, but only to sow it everywhere and among all places. God bless you today, in Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated.
Hey, we make a miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.